Did you know that the code of the iOS Wikipedia app is open source and available for anyone curious to learn about the inner workings of this app? A few weeks ago, I decided to spend 2 hours to explore this codebase because I had a feeling that I could, maybe, learn something valuable. I'm pleased to report that I indeed did learn something very interesting, and that's what I want to share with you in this video. When you're exploring such a massive codebase, you need to focus on something specific. Otherwise, you'll just end up wasting time brushing the surface. So I decided I would focus on one of the core screens of the app, the screens that displays the content of a Wikipedia article. As you can see, this screen allows the user to read the entire content of the article and lets them interact with it. Tapping on a link to another article triggers a push navigation. Tapping on an image displays a new screen modally. And tapping on a footnote displays its details and updates the navbar. At first glance, my feeling was that this screen must have been implemented using either a single UI text view or through a UI collection that contains several UI labels. But when I used Xcode's debugging tool to capture the view hierarchy, I was really surprised to see that it was actually powered by a WK web view. As an iOS engineer that believes strongly in native apps, you can guess that I'm, of course, not the biggest fan of web views. So seeing a web view being used to implement the core feature of a popular app was quite unexpected and unsettling. But thinking about it, this choice actually makes a lot of sense. Wikipedia is first and foremost a website, and its content was created to be displayed using HTML and CSS. Taking that into consideration, it does make sense for the Wikipedia app to use a web view to render its content rather than to spend precious time and energy trying to reproduce the exact same look and feel using iOS native components. However, this doesn't explain one thing. How on earth is this web view able to trigger a native navigation in response to user interaction? This is actually implemented using a very powerful but not very well-known API introduced by Apple with iOS 8 called WK Script Message Handler. What this API does is provide the JavaScript code running inside the web view with a special function that, when called, will trigger native code in the app that embeds the web view. Here's how it works. First, the iOS app creates a bridge to receive messages from the web view. Second, the user taps on a link in the web view. Third, JavaScript code in the web view calls the function webkit.messagehandlers.bridge.postmessage. Fourth, the web view forwards the message to its user content controller. Fifth, the user content controller parses the content of the message. And sixth, native code is executed to run the action that corresponds to how the user interacted with the web view. And this is how tapping a link in a web view results in a new view controller being pushed onto the navigation stack. To be 100% correct, some additional code is also executed to prevent the web view from loading the new page itself. You see, I definitely wasn't lying when I claimed that you could learn some really cool tricks just by spending a couple hours exploring the open source codebase of a popular iOS app. So if you have the time, I would really recommend that you also give it a try and start exploring an open source codebase. I'm sure that you'll learn something useful along the way. You can find two lists of open source iOS apps in the description. That's all for this video. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss my next videos. Thank you for watching and see you next time.